Hello friends, welcome to SQL Server video series. In this video, I am going to discuss how to connect to SQL Server Database using SQL Server Management Studio. The most important point that you need to keep in mind is both SQL Server and SQL Server Management Studio are two different things. Here, SQL Server is the database and SQL Server Management Studio is the client tool that can be used by a user to write and execute SQL queries against the SQL Server database. As part of this video, we are going to discuss the following pointers in details. First, we will discuss how to connect to SQL Server database using SQL Server Management Studio. Then we will understand the different SQL Server types available in SQL Server. And finally, we will understand the authentication while connecting with the database. That is, we will discuss Windows authentication and SQL Server authentication. How to connect to the SQL Server database using SQL Server Management Studio? We need to follow the below steps to connect to the SQL Server database using SQL Server Management Studio. First, click on the Start button, then select All Programs, then select the version of SQL Server that is installed on your machine, and finally, click on the SQL Server Management Studio, which will open the SQL Server Management Studio. Let's understand this practically. So let's click on the Start button, then search for SQL Server Management Studio. So this is my SQL Server Management Studio. So I'm just clicking on this. Once you click on SQL Server Management Studio, then it will open the SQL Server Management Studio window as shown below. So let us understand what we need to select and provide in this window. So the step one is select the server type. As we are going to connect with the SQL Server database, so here we need to select the server type as database engine. Along with database engine, we have also analysis service, reporting service, integration service, Azure SS integration service. So here we need to select database engine as we are going to communicate with the SQL Server database. So along with the database engine, the other service types options available are analysis service, that is SSAS, SQL Server reporting service, that is SSRS, and SQL Server integration service, that is SSIS. These are called MSBI, that is Microsoft Business Intelligence, which we will discuss in detail in our MSBI video series. Let us move to the presentation and understand the role and responsibility of all these server types. What is database engine? The database engine is the core service of SQL Server, which will use for storing a large amount of data, accessing the data, manipulating the data, and providing security to the information. In the database engine, the data will be stored in the form of a 2D format, that is in the form of a tables. The next one is analysis service. The SSAS, that is SQL Server Analysis Service, is a tool that is used under the data warehousing or data mining environment for storing the data or information in the form of 3D format. The next is reporting service. The SQL Server reporting service, that is SSRS, is a tool that is used to generate various types of reports such as MS Word file, MS Excel, PDF, XML, TIFF file format. The report is a document that is used to store some business related information. The next one is integration service. The SQL Server integration service, that is SSIS, is a tool that is used to convert one database table into another database understandable format. For example, SQL Server database tables are converting into Oracle understandable table format. And one more point that you need to remember, the SSAS, SSRS and SSIS tools are coming under MSBI, that is Microsoft Business Intelligence tool. Now let's move to SQL Server Management Studio. So we understand the server type, as we have different type of a server type, and as we are communicating with the SQL Server, so we need to choose database engine as the server type. The second step is to specify the server name, right? The server name is nothing but the name of the SQL Server or The IP address of the SQL server, that is the server SQL server where it is hosted, we need to provide that IP address. And one more thing that you also need to remember is the SQL server is installed on your local machine, then you can also specify the server name as dot or 127.0.1 or local. Here I am specifying the SQL server name as here I am specifying the name of the SQL server as the server name. The step 3 is to select the authentication type, right? The step 3 is to select the authentication type. In SQL Server, there are two types of authentication, that is Windows authentication and SQL Server authentication. But that depends on how you installed the SQL Server. That means at the time of installation, if you select the mixed mode authentication, then you will get both Windows and SQL Server authentication to connect with the SQL Server database, or else you will only have Windows authentication to connect with the database. So Windows authentication is the default authentication mode of SQL Server. In Windows authentication mode, we will work on user admin. With Windows authentication mode, there is no need to enter the user credential, that is user ID and password, because user ID and password are generated by the operating system by default. In SQL Server authentication, we'll work on the current user. So when we work with SQL Server authentication, we should enter the user ID and password. The user ID and password are created by the user at the time of SQL Server installation. How you connect to the SQL Server, it is up to you. I'm using Windows authentication to communicate with the SQL Server database. Once you provide the server type, server name, and authentication, and once you click on the connect button, then we will be connected to the SQL Server database. Once you connected to the SQL Server database, then click on the new query option. This is the new query option, and click here. And once you click on the new query option, then query editor will be open. And this is the editor where you can write SQL queries and you can also execute SQL queries, and that we will discuss in our next video. Let's move to the presentation and understand one more important point. The most important point that you need to remember from this video is that SQL Server Management Studio is not the server. It is the client tool that can be used by a user to connect with the SQL Server database. The database server, that is SQL Server, is generally on a dedicated machine, and the users are connecting to the SQL Server using SQL Server Management Studio from their local machines. For better understanding, please have a look at the above diagram. As shown in the above diagram, the different developer machines, that is developer 1 machine, developer 3 machine, developer 4 machine, developer 2 machines are connecting to the SQL Server database using SQL Server Management Studio. So in the next video, I'm going to discuss how to create, alter, and delete a database in SQL Server using SQL Server Management Studio. Here in this video, I try to explain how to use SQL Server Management Studio to connect with a SQL Server database. I hope you enjoy this video. In case you need the text version of this video, then the link for the same is provided in the video description section. Thank you for watching this video.